Dumelang, rena re khatetse ke go phamolwane. Ke anything e ka phamolang. Re phamolwa ke phamokate, re phamolwa ke gender based violence, re phamolwa ke banna ba re sa ditseneng taba tsa go jola le bona, re phamolwa ke bo mme ba sa re taking care, re phamolwa ke bo sisters ba sa re taking care, re phamolwa ke re ha e bane ka phamolwa jaaka hurricane phamola koloi mo strateng, ra phamolwa. And then my thing, I'm like, I just buy skedem sa go phamolwa. Ga go tsaya wana nje mo lifeng. Nyaya tle. Tlhaloganyang, that thing is not happening. I am not going to just give me a pamulat. Ngiyothathwa nje. Ngiyothathwa. Hi enye nye nenye into la emgaqweni efuna ukungithatha kaze ziningi kanjani futhi nalezi zinto zanalezi zinto zakhona. Lavaya, kawufela lona. Kawufela. To the flames that you are literally going. To the flames of hell. You are presently applying. Like as with a job interview. To become my ancestors. And yet look at your present moral turpitude. We understand what you have to say, you feel sad and you want to live the legacy on and feeling that you are going to be gone, is that basic, they are gone, they are dead. They either were born again or not, and if they were not born again, by Lady Helen. So some of your ancestors that you worship, by Lebacha, Mako Hades, Batwala Haba Rayente, Mara Laba Weship, Laba Weship, and in and of yourselves with this kind of moral turpitude, you are literally interviewing for ancestry one day. Some of y'all, your interview is about to be so successful because lahlanya, lidweba, la lemanza, so mudimo ole bolai. So in 2 months time, utaba so le ancestor obuti. Utaba so le ancestor sister's girl. Mara you will have been applying to be your ancestor thing bophelo ba hao ka ofela. Mara the way ono lo ya ka tenye o le kotse girl. The way ono tletse ka ho fofora batho ka tenye girl. Obuti the way ono tletse ka go bela ka tenye o go betse girl le ba sadi ba foko ofising ka yona go bela ten boy. O he batho. Umuzwenguli, who basic? How about all those about chicken, kankane, umuzwenguli? Alright, let's just put that out there. Mara, zozi ding, you qualify just by mere virtue of being a black person. Le kompita, ngakali din swa langkutra, le luansa ngakali kolobe langkutra, le zayela na bekamoso, ban, le zayela na like, yabatong, di karie. Memereko le tsaela na di biboko le khosa batho ba hlangi ke batho ding tlengi sa batho ka dite ka batho ka ditlhare la initiate le tsaya bo mamlambo cause ni twele ha batho ka hampeli go ke di tikoloshi mara wena hano tsantsa batho ba lo ba go rapella one day kwamele wena yo thandazelwa uyo thandazwa too rara ngoba ngishuzenze u god you dearest grandos you Bantaba mnyama mina ngikhathele yini. Safa saphelisizwe simnyama ngempela. Dala saboda kodwa nifuna ukuyoresurrecta. Umuntu makanizama ngegospel. Nikhulume nyongo nithi. Ungazongitshela mina about white man's religion. Yo! I know, yes, and it's alright. Alright, demolishing. Like, Papa, we're thinking it's all good in the head. Hello, what's the solution, I get it. It's okay, na kita tsamaya ka God, we'll be nice. Mudimo wa ka wa bagoa. Ke a monka. Ke a monka. Ke ta monka nna mudimo wa ka o leng busy ka magwa fela a khositseng Africa ka ofela e lo ba colonized. Ko motsaya ka tsatsi le day o phaphame a kere from the grave in a way that your ancestors didn't. Top of that, ke na o di protecting from tsaya o re Jack the Ripper o mpatla ka nkane by fire by force. Ba nna ba tletseng ka korobela ba ntumpang ka di something tsa. Ba ba tlang hong jesa. Keep me as a puppet on a string. Ba ka khile ndi ka re ka ntse dumba le tlokos ba stinchi ga ba tlo rena ke iperekel. Ba ba tlang hong besa ka nkane. Ba npe ko passenger seat ba ntse ba driver around Johannesburg ka ofela. Mo ba bye ba ke ntse re ke pope mo relationshiping and just nearly exist as a woman. Eh, un protectile from all that. The very same Jesus all is us buying skelem sa lena. Sa sa yena because apparently allegedly o tlokametse magwa and not us. Like it amata because on protectile from like I said the Jack Roller tsetsetsetseng na ga mo South Africa tsempatlanga ka ne by fire by force le o tsirene ngwa kwa America le na umviketse from yena yena the same god on pilen spiritual gift re ke tla khona bona every last thing e phamola mo mostrateng gore nna ke ka tla phamola ke phamokate ke phamola ke monna o ga ke ta go mpha z3 abatle mo re ke nna grace bo mo mfileng yona Na go phamola ke monotong phamolang ka tlapa ka mpama. Na go phamola ke monotong phamolang ka gender based violence ka 6 feet under ka casket ka cadaver ka autopsy ka crematorium vibes. Na monna o tlong phamolang ka selepe or monotong phamolang ka several admissions into sepetlele. Sa public ino khale because na ga ke gona go afford medical aid A. Modimo na o phamotse from leletso go la D monster. Yo na ntho eo e tlhorisang e tshosang. Tshosana seo. That little digolosh of a man. Eh, mudimong phamotse matsogong a bona ka ofela. Without even a single one failing, one kutwa. Ga gona ke le monna o tse, not even all one, o nosi, that has ever prospered to get to me. Anvale busy motho, grinding and grinding and grinding at the mill. Anza za malo tsa a chere sa motshwaneleng. Marankane ya bona le ba batletseng ka first ka teng. Eh, just proves ukuthi grandchap a whole chunk of you women in South Africa le tsailwe, le phamotswe. Because banna ba gabangale, they don't give up. They don't give up. Ke ntho ke llelang. Ba tla go nkela family ka ofela ba nkutla. Abantu ba gini ba zokujikela ngoba le ndoda le ya kufuna ngenkani. Uzokujikela ngabangani. Uzojikela ebathu, if at all it can turn against you. E tla go jikela sister again. Banna ba ba go costa mosadi affiliation. Ke re ga gona ke re thomiyana A1 that got your back. Ga gona ke re le nothing o go godisitse o go change le di diaper. Maleri a imelang antsa a tshetshilwe ke ntatwa teng le ntatwa teng will literally jigela you because o busy o favor tsweba ya narcissist e vimbe yonke family ya konge miti we o kaze sizo enza bo mahwat na re tlo irang rona re lwelwa di family tsa rona re lo jona le bana ba re sa ba batleng ana re ha o kotsi on that day o le mohara relationship ileng ya long le feletseng ka ofela kilili 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 ba ya chata ya msanje but like the men o vimbe ngithi umndeni wakho wonke uanti umalume ugogo nogono grandfather no mama no baba abo sisters your siblings ba favor munna o tla go tumpang ka selempe munna o tla go tshwarang pogo I wait again in an ordinate favor in an ordinate favor like lenga ta lena e ya thandwa ka bantu ba gini noma a bihise ngimpama just 2 weeks ago mothaka o khutswe ditse tshelete ko bank account ong o irile EFT without your knowledge. O wa tsa mme wa hore ba tsong mona ona o nkutse ditse madi. Ga ke na dira dawa ka ofela e feletse cause D1 o entse a little bit of a transfer to himself. O em basically le di funds tsa mina isa ga ke mo bank. No teng a mara no mara o itse ke nge tshepiso ke mwana mina isa. Tshepiso ke mo khonya na wa ka. E ba tsong mme to o nkutle hore ke tseng. Tshepiso nya na o wa ga go mo ratang high and low ho reng ka re he can do nothing wrong. O nkutle mme wena o ntshitsileng mo ntshitsileng ma leri. Did you hear? I just said he stole money from me. E be mo tenga re no mara ka ofela ba batho ba na le diphoso 3000 rand ka ofela ya ka e tsamaile ka re ka ntjene na ya out yena ha you disturb when na ke shabane le yena ke eko tseng tshibile tse pulsating it's beating mo makhanga ga o nkutse tsa tshelete ha ka tamo aba tlo dripa ko mosebetsing hore ke la hlagelwa ke mosebetsi hore na tlo tlokomela ka 3000 rand ya ka and then ke mkhoya yena wa ha basadi nya ya tlhabo ke business le monkeng gang mara haleng rati bokeng. Haleng rat, baitse ke la le mathata. You've got bones to pick with me and ga ke tlhaloganye re grandchap diswa hwen. Di bones tsa lona. Ga ke tlhaloganye girl. Haleng patle mo ke gatileng teng, empa nna ke le zama. Ke tshelo ka re modimo wa ka o wa magoa. Eh, o mphulusitse. From di gebengu tse leng etseng kankan. Se gebengu that you did not want to be with. Ke mo mothako. You walked down the aisle to him. Nyanjo le busy bina ya etsa jeans. Nyanyes. Nyanyan, this come along. You make it look good when you know it ain't. Aren't you justifying the filthy deeds of some random tricksters in these streets that made themselves your husband's kankan and then you make it look like it's good? Ugh. Robot. Robot anyoko. Ro deliver. Ro nababang bakhetileng Jesu Kriste. Kya le kai thutang history, do you understand? Teach yourselves the origins of the gospel. Teach yourselves the nature of God, his attributes, as they are described in the scriptures. That you might comprehend that the only mission that God is doing here on these in these streets is gathering for himself a people for his own possession. That's all that God is doing. And so even if it's through vessels that are cracked, what is the word for it? Treasure in jars of clay, human beings that are full of folly. Nonetheless, he has done no other thing but gather for himself a people for his own possession, by making disciples of all nations. So whether or not the gospel came through you, to you through Rome, whether the gospel came to you through France, whether the gospel came to you through what you call this Russia or Venezuela, Angazi, that South America, whatever, whether the gospel came to you through the United Kingdom, because God uses treasure in jars of clay, cracked up pots that don't make no sense, out here be making happy feet and trotting on along to other continents to do the thing that God will have the human race do. They are flawed. So just because they flogged you and ripped your skin apart with a cat of nine tails, ransacked you with slavery, does not mean that the messenger all be respected above, what do you call this? Above the one who sends the message in the first place, God has gathered himself a people for his own possession through vessels that are disquieting in their indiscretion. So, to say what a little bit of Jesus Christ, because ke lekhoa, first and foremost, I say lekhoa, he's a Jew, all the way from the Middle East, olive skin, learn history. And secondly, y'all need to comprehend hore, if at all the Lord proliferates the gospel to you through your harsh slave master, you still gotta account to him. In your own unique individual capacity, why you rejected the gospel, even though God showed himself to you as the one giving you the word. And not so much Ukarabo, or Peter, or Paul, or some Italian rando. Like, herein lies the deal. You don't get to reject your God, who has shown himself all over creation, based on your indiscretions, your nuances, your biases, or whatever. Especially when your God has shown himself as God, in a way that is comprehensively covering, and the gods that you have rather chosen to worship have displayed themselves as untrue gods. They have displayed themselves as willing at a whim to steal, willing at a whim to kill, and willing at a whim to destroy. Nobody does that but Satan and your little ancestors. Father, liar from the beginning. I get a little two-faced, but there is no one that does that well. Better even than Satan. He masquerades as an angel of light. Big yawning smiles like the Joker. That's what's good. Satan again is untrue, not God. So jaka ga madlozi alona ali thusa ho rollo step abatho in the back. Look betray. Ni busy ka bona ho bane. Le worship Satan ha kana. La dina ya ore ke Satan a ke. La desire la dina ya ore ke diabolo si. Ma fitileng teng. You are in denial, guys. Mara diabolo se ke no utswang. Ke no singang. Ke na obulaya. Janong jaka khaletsa all those things, and then on top of that, letse ka maka, you are two-faced. Your houses are not upon the stone, the rock, but they are on the sand. How on a engwen trek I talang mona fatting mona na? Other than to throw you dihele ni guys in this. Because then the enter you walked in ditsila. Ntwe ditsila ya lahlwa. Another one, are you gonna hold on to an apple core? Ukata hu in nata weja. You don't know, spit it out to its seeds. For eng. Inse blom nese fella khabi sitse. Your pantry go kitchening. Inse oxidize are turning brown in front of everybody. Are you gonna leave that apple core there, or are you gonna put it in the dustbin? Ntwe jilweng e fedizweng, and then ntwe ditsila, ya lahlwa. O ka se nneng tse o le busy wena o holdile on to pakete ya mazimba, pakete ya mazimba. E tlo blow manje fela gathering dust on your kitchen counter, or ko lounge-ong ya gago. O ka se tlotlogela di-popcorn tse o eleng mo fatshe, o sa di fiele. O sa di kenye mo ra dustpan and throw them in the dustbin. Ntwe ditsila ya lahliwa, even though initially, e ne e le ntle e le skone. Letswetswe le le innocente. Mara modimo o tshelo ko lentswe la gagwe gore there's no one who does good. No, not one, for all of sin and fallen short of the glory of God. Top of that, your hearts are deceitful above all things, human beings, and desperately wicked. Le nna ga ke mara nna ke pholositswe. I'm saved by grace. That's what's good. Yeah. So seeing as you become filthy somewhere along the way, and you don't want the substitution of the only person that was both human and God, did not sin, and died for you, a substitutionary sacrifice was done for you. Seeing as I name Funala Gande Kona, because apparently Uzela Nomlung was a Europe, Ambange na Madlozi enu, Angena Maitseo, there were gangsters, there were Mabanditi, your little gangstrosities, your little child molesting daddies that ransacked Lestata Sonke, that cheated on your mamas. Your mamas of which were little local witches. Abantu that indeed deserve ugyolahwa emlilweni ngoba. That's what you do with dirty things. Ntosa ditsila dia lahwa. Liditsila. Hobaneng ile sabona hore liditsila. Just by mere virtue of the bodily feel like guilty hampe. Habotlhoko. Your conscience is a beating on you. It says ukuthi kunentsila that needs scrubbing, that you are not attending to, girl. You're like a person that hasn't taken a shower in days. Abandla we, or you're not gonna walk into heaven and not people be and not have people there be like gunugan lana kinyang. You're not gonna be let in. You're not gonna be let in. Nothing impure enters heaven, yo. So bo naive balona to continue ka di ancestors tse di tshila and then hope that one day in and of yourselves little body ancestors tse di tshila and somehow mix Jesus is going to accept you into heaven having never even tried go loti khotla ga wa thapa ga wa zama lo itlhakola ke re le ganyana ga wa iphumola sefatlhe go nothing ga wa like no stain as wa suga ke re le washing A1 mara batla ke nang magodimo. You let yourself roam around in sin nje izona zenu piling up to the skies dibetsa lona tse 20 million ka letsatsi di business di heap up the nostril of God like a nasty stench in a dustbin. There was a place called Gehenna in the Bible. That was a place that was full of burning where people threw litter, like a waste site that constantly was burning because that was the best way to dispose of the dirt. So jaanong, seeing as lidisila lelahletswe ko molong, why lilla? Litabelela weeping and gnashing your teeth for all of eternity, regretting the way you could tell in your consciences that this is not going to end well. This is not going to end well, mara litabeletswetse pele, little guys, little girl, most sisters, little brother. Nkabele tso tsipele ka nyoko. Eh, ya batho ba bang tsheli tso re motho wa bona tsika tong tsana ka Jesu. Ehle. Ha hona o mong. And no other name under heaven by which men must be saved. Ha hona o mong motho se kileng a phela without a single sin. O le modimo as well, true kamo. Eh, hi. Other than God. Marley bizlo na le worship ba bo anti ba baloi. Ba tloka fetseng grants up thanks to a satanic ritual gone wrong. Mara ke mzali ke ke ba mmisang. Ke dzozi ya ga. Kensi, sister girl Kensi, lo ena body le crash abudlong tso korola di cherry ko office, mara you are vying to be an NC. In 2 weeks you're gonna pass away, your family are gonna worship you. Abantu ba gina ba gonna worship. O ka re bo yantela 99. Eh, hello lo ka tle. E be le motshimpa ka ignore. Ka control alt delete. Yeah, nyempe. Tanenti. Hey, just like artificial intelligence, it appears to me like you are reaching singularity, black people. Ke khathetse ke TikTok. And nante busy in recommend batho ba defeatisti, ba tipola yang, ba ti shutang mo futung. Ke grand ka lona my lifeing. Ke grand, ke grand. Ke grand batho ba bang sweet king le busy in tsela enjoy ya mareu a satane. Leading you to the flames of hell. Sa batho go correct, le kampane nna lang pata, lang king ya mara le ka sentse ke phela. Ana re mo lifeing ho baneng ke le go hospicing, ke le healthy ga kan. Ga ke na kankere, mara ke na le cousin e ntse ke busy batla go mfa cancer. That's what's good. Mara ke a phela, and ke le cancer teng, yeah, e batla go mphamola. Mara ga e mphamole, gobane ke na le mvikele, ka mela ke go Jesu Kriste. A ntlhaloganye, that's the thing. I have a protector that is making sure that I don't get the cancer that my cousin is trying to curse me with. I have a protector that is ascertaining that I ngikapitulate mina to eat Jack Roller. I don't get that anje as umfazi ngingamfuni. Ndoda ngithi angifuni kodwa. Oh, inhlupheko. Inhlupheko angifosta yona ungitshela ukuthi karabu uzongithatha cause awuzokhona ukuyothenga noma ukuthengisa. You're not gonna be able to know gakisa disigila muni on the side of the street ga o tlogona gape le go reka makikip bathong ba abutine jana ga ke galetse makikipi ke iketseng ga ke batla ice cream icing yan ga ke batla kota abuti is telling me hey o tla ja dust o tla ja lerole karabu because mom I say khana motho o tla khona go reka kota unless nna ang shapaka le roma yo inkane ngaka mina ngizo yenza ngizo yenza ngiyakhala khalilili ke khathetse nna di edit aka di edit di hip up to the mountains because I ke khona to get her to my work on time because of the level of spiritual abuse I'm enduring at the hands of abo fostoms abonkanoms amadoda anene inkani ne fost bangifuna ngempenye inkani. Mthatha mo tlhale ka rga Justin tshi ha batho mo sa dira itsebeletse mara tshwantse nna ke lo montsa ya nyai junior vu manyai ona yo rona go igirala soso le Amanda Black ntse giving a pina to a man that has not had it coming to deserve mfazi o zi thobile to God ga go ikokobetsa nna mo no sna maitse wa nkutla. I am not going to humble myself to a man that does not love Jesus. I guess bye. Mono ndali busy ati misa ka di ancestors tsene di bodletse ne di banditi di bank robber di tlokafetse e mothatelalo di worshipa. It is no wonder lena as na maitseo just like those bank robber uncles as like his andala as the bodile that he now worships as amadlosi now ya judge now ya judge now he's a little bit of a banditi now u busy ya mtisha i stand a back ne SNP uya tonda lo muntu kodwa ka miliko gomelo u tsayo ba umnyeni wa tsantsa ba mana wa mina isa ke grand demolishing and a bogel ke lena molishing le tsetse tsetse naga le sengetsa ka robo ka mosa because leng foster re go nyala di bank robbera tsa lona leng foster bona ba di tumpile ba le phamotse ka phamokate mothateng o go file HIV because o busy ka di sex ritual and the occult tsa di orgy a sa sebedise le condom How could that more ever look so good to my nagging by my link slap, ever again? Because I let spies get themselves and naked by the one person that escapes that bullet. That's the thing. Hey? That's the thing. Psalm 91. 1,000 may fall on your side, 10,000 on your right hand, but it does not come near you. I am protected because I have worshipped one God. Your polytheism is literally slicing and dicing you like carrots on a chopping board. Ian Mosha, Ian Bulala, your polytheistic view. I can't do anything I worship you, but what I mean is a Nike Kimuhu. Kimuhu, I think it is more. I can smoke cuttings. Even though I'm trying to reach Abo chicken here. Listen, all right. Jaka ha lechapele di tswa gabo tlhoko gakana. Kidi khare tsa bana. How long do you think you are going to be safe in your cities, your countries? Jaka ha lechapele di tswa gabo tlhoko gakana ke bana ba thwetseng. Batho. Another little infector. South Africa ka fela ka ngolaza se baka se sekakang. Monna gyo, tshantso lo kwatela yena. O go file ngolaza ke zinis. Because o busy ntse robala robala mo mo strateng. Lidi satanic ritual tsa gagetse ding tsintsi mo strateng ba tla fika. A tla robala lona go jarateng. Another ho baneng le kwatetse karabo with a clean bill of health. When ntho ena na grand shop eng potitileng ke taba hore I gave my life to Christ and then I became celibate. And then I waited on God for husband online se ba Jesu. Hore aska tlong tlotlorana ka ditlhare first and foremost and hore naska tlong tlotlorana ka mamlambo mo go di marofo ya ntla rona hore naska tlong tlotlora hape ka infidelity at your fraternizing with everything in these streets or skirt chasing rando hore hape aska tlong tlotlora ka spiritual manipulation cause naked like a lawyer ke monna minaisa ke tlokometswe ke Jesu to be protected from all such activity as that ebe le tlokwatela nna instead of acknowledge hore nna ke kgethile right Nekonne in your defeatism lintseleng tematalangkutla. Le khosa hore ne ke no gabi so mo strateng. Even though I ought to be more functional than ornamental. Where does that I find myself? Purely because ba le tlhurile lena. Ebelela dikeledio. Hehe le hobola. Ja ga dincha. Ga the same type of brother. Alo tsa ya ngwana ha wangwanyana. Le duplicitous aiker. You have got double standards aiker. Ha le tsepe ga ke mo tsetse ka backstabbing. So because you're duplicitous, double standards, that's what you do. You would not want the same fate that befell you to befall your daughters. And yet, kodwa, abangani benu, peripherally, horizontally, your girls, I know, up for grabs. Bona, it's all systems go. Di mpenche sa make all systems go, mara ising bana babanyana, and this thing is going to be proliferated nkare ke bathono. Relay race, ko Olympiking. It's going to be proliferated. So you ignore me, you ignore your Gen Alpha child, your girl child. You are liteng, you bong tate bateng. Bong tate babo Gen Alpha, ne? Le bona ga ba batle bana ba bona ba banyana hore ba lo rabatswa ke bana ba tshwanang le bona mara karabo tsa for grams it's like other people's daughters are you can just take it other people's daughters it's okay mara ile bana ba bona baba overprotective overzealous okay you see a father can try and protect his daughter from a man like him mara ha ngwana ngwana a tsa ile ke korobela a le dizzy ngwana batho a le mesmerized ke di tlhare tsa jabu ha na ntenta to a ka ietsang the only protection that your daughter got is somebody supernatural spiritual that can block le mitia lenja from working on her kota ani funu fundisa bantwana benu u Jesu ngoba nina ani funu kuzifundisa Jesu self you don't want to go to the only protector you don't want to go to the only what is this the only concealer the only one fisa from moment of tabolile the only one o ka go patang do you know gore hona le banna bang phasileng up lang kutla ba tsile kwa nna bang shapata peace sign cuz they thought they were cute banna no baba fashionable due to tabo rene ke sna mereko just by mere virtue of me having no money being kind of poverty stricken I get like sutlwe ke tlhopego ke banna ba insisting on tsaela career le bo chicken but at this point they utilized indaba ukuthi mina nginam sebenzi against me ngazi bwanga ignore nga madoda that would have shelled me in droves literally flying to me and got a whole hive of bees when I was employed khani ke sebetsa ne bang patla high and low ke shelwa ke le motho wa di DMs bursting at the seams pressed down shaking together and running over no end in sight to the number of men that were vying standing queuing in line to take my hand in marriage kota usomandla wangifihla god buried me in what you call my curse my poverty into pego yam go tlhophega gwaka go nthusitse gore ke hore bana ba ba senang maitseo ba senang morals ba senang what is this like ba shallow what is it gaining shanty vacuous hollow ashy Men with no real substance wanted nothing to do with me the moment I lost a job. I dodged a bullet from a dude that I thought was my husband. Simply because a case was raised up, trumped up against me at MTN, he caught wind of it in the rumor mill, and all of his flirting with me suddenly went ice cold. Ya vele ya freeze, ya begwa inside dry ice, never to be resuscitated. Intruzam may be sure, intruzam may sure, mukodwa. I dodged the bullet. Usomandla can not only vigela your daughters from Corbella working at all if somebody has set their eyes on them, but he can also hide your daughters from men that naturally are just kind of fair weather. Abashelo, do you understand? Abatembeki. He is going to go out on you the moment you are no longer as attractive because your nose is this big because you're carrying a boy through during a pregnancy. You've got stretch marks for days on your stomach. Your cellulite is starting to appear in parts where it never was. And so, cause lenja lena is shallow. All of a sudden, a woman that looks like you prior to the pregnancy is going to be out here satisfying the needs of your husband. Amatodanjalo. Anyena ride or die. A single bone in their bodies of holding on to a woman from like till death do us part, always enjoying the breasts of the wife of his youth. Amadoda. Anjalo. Oh God, we as will face from them. Do you understand? Jesus Christ can hide your daughters and you from a man that would, if at all, you were to literally have one hair fall out of place. If at all, for one day you can't lay your edges right. Lenda Lena is going to show you flames. A fair weather rando. God can hide you from him by simply putting you in poverty before you can go on a date with him. And that's what he did with me. Nga ignora and got passed up by guys that were queuing to be with me. Because of the fact that I lost a job. Something so basic as that. Amadoda, are they not supposed to be the ones to provide? Aren't they supposed to feel proud to have take care of umfazi makasutlegile? And yet, lamadoda wa 21st century sham. Ah. Ukuyo hlokomela a woman. Onyena what they call clout. Ah, sham. To him, it's like, you're going to tank my statistics. You're going to plunge my stats. Yeah. You sound like Cher from Clueless, the way they're so effeminate. Ngabogel. Ngabogel, God can protect you from an effeminate man that does not see his responsibility to take care of a woman through thick and thin. They don't make them the same no more, do you understand? Manje mina, njengoma ngivikelwe ngintlupheko yam, my very poverty has protected me. Lingzondela dabaore, I dodged the bullets that you fell under because you kept your career, you kept your degree, you kept on studying, you kept on gathering for yourself currency by the standards of this world. And then some dude looked at you and said, you make sense for me. And then wa muchata nga ba khofa phamoka re guys, wait again. I'm trying to get to a point. Amadoda lana a thwele. Go thwele left and right. Like go thwelwe. Ga botlhoko gampe. And then nna ke alla hona no because ke batla ha ya no ke banna ba thwele engwe kutla. And it's bang batla because ho tlie. Hore ntho ke yentseng e right, ke kgethile right. Mara after the act, I'm seriously envied. And the seriousness of it is because I am literally dying in front of people. And I can't help but rock up here and make it evident, clear, highlight that hakuna any of you botigin chigin lang kaluhanya that are safe. None of you are safe. I was on TikTok and I'm playing Jayazin. I'm not just ranting hanga matota, but bottom line is they're the ones that God has given authority headship to run the show. And when they drop the ball, all of society falls apart. God to Abba Fazi, they have a responsibility to play. You've got to do better. You need to be godly. Ma godly uya vigelwa, wa ma godly uya fihlwa from wicked men. When you are godly, you basically dodge bullets that other people don't dodge. There's not enough of us dodging bullets. So we are all in some strange grain as black people, and the only people, abai 5 or 10, that have protected themselves through the protecting power of Jesus Christ. Halisari tlobara ka mona wa lona heba na bo cherry. Halisari tumpa ka disregard. Halisari tumpa ka tlhoriso ya gore ignore. Halisari neglect. Saruri hure ha bo eba tsho. Halisari tswa go gona keng. Di cases tsa gona tsa GBV ha di sa ignore because rona re ha no lo robala le bana ba tsirianeng. Ha ke dikeng. La ba thusa. You are helping wicked men to get to the last of us that are sober. The remnant, eselemva, that did not capitulate to yonke le nonsense la mkatweni. You are helping men keep us poor. Tlhopego ya ka nna ke a le ka tlhaloganya a kere. Ee. E manufacturilwe ko magodimong. Ke jopo la nkuntla. The Lord used it to protect me. What was intended for evil, the Lord used it for good. The saving of many lives. I am protected. Ke tshireleditswe, guys. It looks as if though ngishiwe kodwa kuimpossible ukuthi ngishiwe mina ngoba God made it clear that he will never leave nor forsake us. He made it evident that no such thing will ever be a thing. So uma ufila ngathi uyekelwe or ushiwe or ulahliwe, it's not true. You gotta basically demolish arguments and every lofty pretension that exalts itself above the Most High, and hold into captivity every thought to the obedience of Jesus Christ. I'm being so distracted. Honale, a whole bunch of noise on the outside and a whole bunch of people walking around. So I'm going to try and talk through it, okay? Nonetheless, and just talk through it. TikTok. Hey guys, TikTok recommends. Oh goodness, like please, like give me a break. I need peace. TikTok recommends black content strangely to blacks. And I was just showered by it, offended by it, repulsed by it, because of stories that I could relate to. Like, you know that a person has been raised up by Mudimu when they are not happy that other people are able to relate with their sorrow. In the black community, abantu bazi Kenya nendaba yokuthi akusiyimi njengiyiwani, sonke sisuthlekhile, sonke sibhihlizekile, sonke siravazwe yi circumstance. Yo, ayishe. And then you expect abanye abantu la emgacweni on the outside of our race ukuthi basithembe futhi basithande. Singazithandi. Hade bade. Like just the ability to relate. Kula ma TikTok mina I was like, kaze singakhi la emgacweni? Singaki. And the thing that broke my heart was the fact that some white woman made a comment and said, I can't believe how many people are saying, mina, this is my story too. Abanye abantu are looking at us ingathi siyiserekisi lankutla. Ridi popai. And on top of that, ridi popai is a tetswing parafini. Khoswa ka fela gore mechisi yo light wa rocha. Because we are going to hell in droves. Ridi popai batho abantu ene aguna muntu o confused nga that thing. Lankatwen bonke abantu bayazi ukuthi we are defeatist in the worst way. Ke khata ziki TikTok mara. Kimo yang recommend and thotsetse na crash up, I don't want to watch. You know, there was a time when I would actively avoid black culture. Like I would South African culture in particular. Like ngiyabaleka guys. Like as in flee from sexual immorality. Black community insanity is like sexual immorality to me. I just don't want to see it. It's so grieving. On YouTube, I actively avoid it. So YouTube has started recommending to me appropriately. It's like I'm living vicariously through other people because I cannot experience gladness as a black person in a black country with all this black defeatism. So I'm living vicariously through everyone else not in my country and everyone else not in my skin tone. I'm living vicariously through white women. I'm living vicariously through Puerto Rican women, Argentinians, Italian. I am living Chinese. I am living vicariously through other women that don't experience the daunting feats that black girls have to just go through by mere virtue of being born in the skin tone. I am living vicariously through them. I long to just be loved and appreciated and respected and have me automatically protected by mere virtue of being a woman. I long to have the protections that white women have under their men and all other races, frankly. Eating Japan. Any kind of disquiet concerning how they are breaking us. Angazi wakwinye na conscience in the black community. Angazi guys. Angazi ngoba sonke. Usomandla usinikeza the same faculties. He gave us an ability to have a conscience. So us not exercising it. Us not exercising it as black people. I can't understand why black people don't hearken to their consciences. It's not like you don't have them. It's like, I need andaba. It doesn't do anything to you. Indaba yokuthi sihlekisa kangaka. Abantu bayasihleka. Aninandaba. Halinandaba. Le ka ntlong ka ngwana lona. Le motlogela sotlhege 10 years ka ofela jwang. Alo ravaza alo blomiso le banna ba tshirianeng. Ba tletseng ka korobela jwang. Ba itsoditseng gore ha e bana ba tlo ba le nna karabo o tlo boda jwang. How can women listen to a woman suffer like this? A white chick that has a kind of intimate, what do you call this, like presence? As me. Suffering through what I'm going through nyantala manj. Especially if mega muhle. Ashem. Menye ga blome in that situation for too long. Menye. Kodwa thina siyayekelwa nje ukuthi sibole. Rebole. Magotet and everything. Relo jiwa runa kidi hyena. Relo jiwa runa kidi. The one of the scavengers. Like people that are literally plundering us for scraps. Ingathi ha riba thoka ofela ba feletseng. Ba need dignity. Come for respect. Asithandwa. As black women. Kunzima. That's why there's always this eventual end result of angry black women in us. Manga chando as a woman, even though God said men love your wives as Christ loved the church, uzokunu kwatilenji uhlala ublowa isteam on the rooftop kodwa amadoda ethu even though abathandi masirasa. They get us to a point of ukurasa kangakuhlunga njena. Guys, how in the world are you going to be going through the same things over and over and over again? Hale batli thuso. Le ratile the ancestors tsalona go mara ha di le tsetse anything. Your ancestors have no regard for ugu. Indaba yokuthi abafazi babantu bamnyama basuthlegile guys. Black women resuthlegile and our ancestors, your ancestors are benandaba. Abenanda, they are not even trying to eradicate the problem. If anything, they are worsening it. The whole epidemic of polygamy is on the rise. Oh God, when I can see, it's written in God's word that if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, repent, basically something along the lines of turn your lives back to God, I will heal your land. So the plight of women in the black community, anizozuzwakala guys, halutho ukuqala. Until such time that you wash your garments and you cry out to God from a pure heart, having truly given your lives over to him, without mixing oh God na my ancestors and all different kinds of other nonsenses land gatwen, you are not going to get heeded. Halutho mamelo la nkuta bathwantsho. But girl, you are not going to get heated. And my ancestors wenu have displayed ukuthi abenandaba nani. We keep on getting clobbered. Baby daddy culture is on the rise. Siyachitelwa nje, amadoda have no incentive to do differently ngoba niyabasiza. And you keep on praying to all these mini gods, your polytheism. Ngiyanibulala. And when then things reach a height where it is that, like I said, celebe on our necks ngari difate, you still don't want to turn to God. Instead, you insist ukuthi akiza so ba hayi toba nakili one wa selepe momolaleng. Tsantsa dipentsa ka go fela ga di 10. Skim ka go fela sa di chere sa go skotsa go high school. Ka go fela rena le 10 rongela nyoko. Or ha rongela at all. Ka go fela le 10 rongela nyoko. Black girls literally would much rather all 10 of them as a crew of friends from high school. They would much rather go fail, take in their stride. Do you understand? Ke tlile ka montle because let's have a look at my company go fela ba le 10 ba sotlega ba company ba go fela ba le 10 go be botlhoko ba company go fela ba le 10 ba utlwise ba keng ba rabaswe and ba ka se go tlogele. They will not leave you alone if you are yet to fall apart under the same thing. We are dying as black women because black women refuse to stop the chain of insults, the spate of attack, the cycle of violence. It does not stop because we are ungodly. We are ungodly. And I've been saying it over and over again on TikTok. Now that I'm outside, I want to move on to the floor from the floor up. It's okay. It's having a bad day, okay? We won't stop the spate of violence, Tina, as black girls, because we feel angry. We feel and feel the need to proliferate nyoko ena, spreading like a gangrene to the next man and the next man. Kharabatlo ba the only ones suffering. Marana, my thing is, chickies, you hurt each other in your own crew of friends. But lastly, halibabo mme, halibatlo bo gelba lona, your daughters, to suffer the same fate as you. But inevitably, they will. And you women who are happy to proliferate this nonsense against your friends, you might think now that your daughters, you don't want them to suffer as you suffered. But once your daughters become beautiful young women, you will be such a narcissistic mother that you will be prepared to either block your daughter's marriage or block your daughter's prosperity in a marriage, or you will literally stand with the guy olingong that your daughter was right to leave until Eyakwin Dotagazi has now passed away at the hands of the very same guy that you said go back. Onzo biza nyoko ya monna mokwenya. Women become narcissistic mothers when they were narcissistic up-and-coming women. You might, when your daughter is still 17 or maybe 15 or maybe 12, be super protective and not want any stupid, ugly menace in these streets to molest your kid, accost her in the park, castigate her in school. You might indeed, as that young mother with a young daughter, be protective initially, but trust me, and I speak from experience, once your daughter becomes a beautiful young woman, once your daughter becomes basically the stuff of Miss South Africa, once when how wang wanyana, when I run this foundation, you can see it's like literally oozing or emanating off my face as I speak, so I'll try and keep the camera stable that it might not be evident that I'm wearing fake makeup. Okay, once your daughter becomes a beautiful young woman and enough for a mom to essentially envy or covet the glory of her daughter, once every guy in the mall is now staring at your daughter as you do as you buy groceries, etc., that's when a woman that did not deal with the issues concerning abusive men or gender-based violence or whatever, when she didn't deal with them when she was on the come up. That's when it starts to rear its ugly head in literal sabotage. Literal sabotage. Like, I bet you have heard of stories of moms who were prostitutes when they were on the come up, literally setting their daughters up to do prostitution in the future. But when this kid was 4 or 5, she would have done everything to protect that girl from evil men. Like, I don't know if you know that song. Rockabye baby, rockabye, I'm gonna love you, rockabye baby. Yeah, women are like that. In the beginning stages, moya ona is going to be very, very loud. Okay, mofonuyaka. That song, yeah, rockabye baby, rockabye. I actually want to chill in one position because with this for camera, I can't, I can't move around too much because then this like filter just keeps falling apart. And I'm like, oh, I want to stay, but I want to stay, but I can tell like that the wind is probably like on my speaker. But anyway, whatever. Initially, when the kids are young, like I had a very protective mom when I was in high school. Every time I would come back home crying, she'd be like, "King, king, king, did somebody touch you? Did somebody touch you? Did somebody touch you?" And I was like, "Whoa, okay, you're taking it too far. I'm crying because my friends were mean. I'm crying because something else happened, basically." Okay, yeah, she was very protective when I was a kid from men that, like, from men, basically, like whatever that men could do to a woman, my mom was protective. But then I became a beautiful young woman on the come up, and that's when she started to basically recommend that I get back together with a whack ex. That's when she started to recommend, be envious of the prospect of me getting married and whatnot. When you don't deal with them, your 4 or 5 year old, maybe even teenage daughter, might enjoy a loving mom that is very protective, but somewhere along the way, that veil of wanting to protect your daughter flees, and it is replaced by a narcissism that then causes women to essentially set their daughters up for failure. If you don't deal with it, you are going to be a narcissistic mother. It happens like clockwork. So you initially will sing, "Rockabye, baby, rockabye, I'm gonna love you." She tells me, "Ooh, love, I'm gonna take care of you, love. Na 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 na, my love. Na 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 na, you." Initially, the mother will be like that. But if she doesn't deal with her issues, if she does not turn to God, she is going to start off saying, "I'm saying, ooh, love, I'm gonna take care of you, my baby, girl." Only for her 24, 25-year-old daughter to now be thrown under the bus by the same mom that would have jumped in front of a moving truck to protect her baby girl from a wicked man. Same protections extracted from the ecosystem by the same mom that would have killed a man that even so much as looked at her daughter some kind of way. Now the same mother is shoving that daughter in that man's face. Today I'm enduring that kind of sorrow as a woman whose mom never dealt with her issues. And so now, horrible, like wicked, disgusting men literally think I'm up for grabs and I'm takeable and have never been loved. Even though there was a time when I was extremely protected by my family, by my own mom, who would have like literally chopped off the head of some funny weirdo that looked at me strangely. Yeah, the same woman is now being trusted, do you understand? To basically stand back and do nothing for her daughter. When I was maybe 16, 17, let's say 16, we used to live in Alberton, and I used to take taxis home, right? Where I would get off Goody Taxing, I would have to walk some distance to get home, and I would pass by this one fast food joint where they used to sell slap chips and what have you, okay? There used to be this one dude that worked there at that slap chip joint, and this guy would get out of his work premises and follow me home. And Zhang Shela, and Zakirin, "No, I don't want to talk to you. No, I don't want to talk to you." And it got to a point where it was really scary because he would follow me almost all the way home, and so therefore know where I stay. And I kept saying, "Leave me alone, leave me alone," very audibly, sometimes even screaming at him, pushing him on the street. He wouldn't leave me alone. And one Friday, I go home and I finally tell my mom. Okay, because initially I didn't tell my mom. I thought I could deal with this myself. I finally tell my mom, "Guys, if I tell you," it was on Friday when I went to go tell my mom. On the Saturday, we were going to Eastgate to go shopping for groceries. The Saturday before we went to Eastgate, Rifti Loko, that fast food restaurant where that guy works, and my mom threw a scene, Langkutwa, a scene, like a scene, at that place where this guy worked, basically threatening that if you don't stop following my daughter around, you and your whole establishment is going to see flames. She went and spoke to his boss and was like, "If you don't get your son to leave my daughter alone, If you don't get your son to leave my child alone, if you don't get your employee to leave my teenage daughter alone, because she's just a child, for crying out loud, y'all, you haven't seen the last of me. Get on inside the flames. Don't look at me looking like a woman. I'm gonna show you flames. Leave my child alone. She caused a scene to a point where the people dining at that restaurant were literally staring, and it was just like, whoa, that dude, I'm pretty sure he got a talking to by his boss. I'm pretty sure he also was very embarrassed for the rest of the day, but he never followed me again. He never gave me a grief again. That kind of protection, when I turned 24, 25, it just fled out the window, because I just became too glorious, too beautiful, and I was now of marriable age. I was no longer a child. I didn't have any more baby fat cheeks. I didn't have pretty much what it is that causes women to not be too intimidated by girl children. Now I was scary to a woman that's a little bit older. Do you understand? And so for those reasons, she stopped protecting her child. She stopped protecting her kid. That is what happens when you don't deal, guys, with your narcissism. I'm sitting on 5% with battery power. When you don't deal with narcissism, that's what under heaven happens. You will literally leave your girl children out on a limb to get taken by just about anything. There's none respect even in the slightest for basic protocol. Yeah, and you will be shocked as a mom, you turning against your daughter like this, but you won't be able to control it, and your daughter will also be shocked at how much you are not protecting her when historically you used to do it so easily. Let me go charge the phone and then come back and have finish having this particular discussion. Yeah, basically what I'm getting at is that there is no safety in complacency. There is no safety in complacency. I hope to be able to use whatever daylight hours remain. There is no safety in complacency. Literally, absolutely none. Hello, Nord and Ash. There is no safety in complacency. Women, do not say that you were not warned. Alright? Just so you can understand, King Egan, that has caused me to sort of kind of blow steam concerning what I saw on TikTok. It was just a whole bunch of TikToks, alright? Of women not only lamenting against... where's my nose? Itchy. It was a whole bunch of women lamenting against infidelity, making jokes about it, basically just the embracing or the acceptance of girlfriend culture amidst married men. That was like a whole thing. And there's one TikTok that's doing its rounds right now, where it is that it's the voice of some dude speaking to his girlfriend while his wife overhears, talking about how it is that it's you that I love, I only married for the children, blah blah, etc. And it's made like a whole big chunky joke. And I went into the comments section of one of these TikToks. There's a few of them doing their rounds, and the number of women in that comment section saying, mine said I was his sister, mine said I was his maid, mine said I was his cousin, mine said that we are roommates. Mine, basically, a married man telling his side piece girlfriend, don't leave me now that you have discovered that I'm married, because I'm not even all that serious with with my wife. Yeah, like that. And the number of women that were in the comments section talking about how it is that my husband literally told his mistress or his side piece that I am a domestic worker in his life. That's what's going on over there. Were so many that one woman, you could tell with her profile picture that she was a white woman. Her comment was in that comment section, I can't believe how many women are able to share their side of the story concerning this thing, saying that mine was this, mine was that. Essentially, this white woman's comment was, how many of you out there are there like this, who have husbands literally pleading with side pieces after they get busted for extramarital affairs to stay with them, talking about how their wives are sisters, cousins, maids, etc., roommates? This woman was in shock. She was in disbelief as to how many of us black women have this to relate with. And my thing was, my point exactly, bullseye, donkey. We are all like that. We get to a point where we have so embraced the indiscretion of men that we then comfort one another with the fact that we can relate.
until other people look in from the outside, observe this indiscretion, and are shocked out of their minds at it, and then say, how many of you are there exactly going through the same nonsense? I hate that I can relate with black women on these issues. I hate that I can do nothing but relate with black women on these problems, because there shouldn't be so many. Look, there are white women who go through nonsense at the hands of men. There are white women who go through nonsense at the hands of their men. Okay, it happens. Sorry. It happens to everybody. It happens to the best of us. It happens to the worst of us. Right? Where it is that we're dealing with indiscretion at the hands of men. Fine, it happens. But the scale that it happens in the black community is frankly unacceptable. The scale is so voluminous that other people literally comment along the lines of, but how many of you exactly are there? White men cheat, Indian men cheat, everybody cheats. And they all come up with stupid, ugly excuses. But the scale of our men, you know, walk in this indiscretion, because, yeah, guys, it's too much. It is too much. There are literally too many of them. Too many. And the whole phenomenon of mothers becoming betrayers of their daughters is on the ramp up, it's on the increase, where your once protective mother is now going to throw you at the hands of wicked men. And I'm lamenting right now because I don't have sufficient protections under my female family members. Because the same people who were once upon a time happy to protect me from the same thing that is currently hitting me now are leaving me be, because I'm a grown woman. I'm a grown woman. They will protect their teenage girls, maybe their toddler, preteen. But the moment you become a beautiful young woman, it's like something competitive rises up in them. It's a generational demon in black women. It's a generational curse. We throw each other to the dogs. The same batch of girlfriends that would have been happy to report the indiscretion of your boyfriend now are going to protect him. Now they're going to protect, they're going to hide his indiscretion at your expense. They will watch you walk down the aisle to a man that has cheated with one of them and not tell you until you are in it. And now it becomes a whole scandal. Napagati. It's like they all want us to suffer the same things. They all want us to be like Janet Jackson and Why Did I Get Married? Out here contracting HIV from a man that you are married to. They want everybody to share the same pain. And this complacency then translates to the circus. Just the incredible circus that is the black community. Que se requis. It is a circus, and I'm tired of being in it. Ke apere letlalo. Leng peileng ha se rekise e ke sa batleng. Lang kutla batho bantsho. And how nan tshenka yetsang ho lo escape this thing. So ke forced to already ke bua le batho ba sa batleng ho mamela. I am forced to keep talking sense into people's heads that I've been speaking sense into for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years. Ho neng ke bua, ho neng ntse ke le here. Ntse ke complain. Ke sa thuse. It appears as if though I am destined or doomed to pass away. Nzekela, got the same things. Amadoda eno angeke bayenze into different until nina. Nizi thoba, likokobetsa kopela Jesu. Repent that you might be protected from them. And you see the thing about not feeding a beast. Hale sa fepe, pohofolo. Ekima edza enze pulsator ehema. Inhaler, exhaler. Nzoli busy wena nzoi fanama. Every 2 days, The thing about a pulsating beast is that it will thrive because you keep feeding it. But if you starve it, it might actually see or something is wrong with the way I am. Basadi ke habaka papa mabatso ge, because bana ba entitled, they have been getting fed inyama ya matotagazi ba banya bantu ba yasibulela nje kalula. Go easy for them to do a death spell on a woman because she said no, I afuna ukujola naye so lo muntu lo uzombulala ne some kind of strange thing. Ba batla ho long ka nna ke le mzalane ka ofela ke feletse gaka na ke le consecrated having been celibate for 13 years. Ba batla go nketsa mistress nahan. How can you know? You can't say no. Because I'm into lama babogile. Mamas, you will at some point, for your 16-year-old daughter that you think you're protecting right now, when you ignore my case, when this daughter of yours turns 23, you are going to recommend that she stays with an ugly man. A bad man, Ontonjali Mali. I had a boyfriend that used to steal money from me in the past. My mom was busy calling him Makoti. And I was like, well, you're not there, my cousin. My mom was like, I like him. He's mukwayana mom. That's the thing. They infiltrate the minds of our parents. They infiltrate the minds of our sisters. Like, family ya hauka fela. Itla ho jiela. In favor of a guy osa etseng sense. O kana o nyetse twebo wa nkutwa. O nyetse nja ka fela e feletseng ntse hobola. O hobola mo jarateng ya hao. O tlo nyala. Because no how o mo ratela eng hao tse. Ha o tlhaloganye hore mwa teng o ratelang monna o khutsetsang tshelete. Wa hutswa motho. He steals money from you. And yet o ma wakho o zo mo favor. It's because basebenzisa imithi to mind control abantu bagini. Until when are you feeling that maybe you are the confused one here to want to walk away? And then you end up so crazy miserable. Emthathweni ungayenzi sense that when now you are divorcing, when come to say, because I need to go and must divorce a song, go fella had a divorce a homonat, go fella had a dumper and trap where a trap were homonat. Go fella, her experience had the same gender based violence. Come on, I need to have a man in tandem and borea my man too. It's like you all want to wear a my leopardy this cement. You want to be wearing cast, go fella, little para, limpa, go fella, little bandage, go fella, go fella, transfer law admit her nogo bar. Because that's the only time that you're going to be content with your fellow man being next to you, content. Lebata go fella, raw para the bandage. So we need to be in some kind of a, you know, medical condition. Otherwise, I could have right. Kutonzi skin go fella sabanyana by 10, bako high school. Go fella rolo balangolaza. Go fella rebele positive test results for HIV. Reinfectula gibana barom. That's the only time that you will leave your girl to be. Khujwalo in the black community. Kisaragisi. White women can endure, relate to the sorrow of the black girl. One or two of 10 of them. Mara, not literally the whole community. It's in Banaka Fair. There might be one or two or three that can relate with our crazy stories, but not the whole community. Same thing is true for Indians and Khalids, etc. Tina Godwa, indaba zethu ezinde ezibolile yezethu zonke. Ka ufela rona, we are suffering from the same thing. Ka ufela. And that is something that black people are content with. Aba mama, balahlela abantu indodakazi zabo under the bus. Aba baba, they stand back. Kya thakathwa, amadoda athwele, athatha abafazi that don't belong to them. And the ones who keep saying no, like Abu Karabo, they are telling themselves that it's only a matter of time. It's only a matter of time. Lamadoda don't heal. Unless you decide to do a better thing as a woman. Unless Nina, Ezba Fazi, and Sanyene, Nonke, make a decision to stop feeding the beast. Aguzo Lunga, Aguzo Namundozo Pola, Kahuna, anybody that's going to be permanently discharged from Les Bezala, Les Nistandoranga, any standard. Specialist Siratang, to keep on getting admitted into Kahuna Moto Oto Zwango Specialing Sateng, Asa Hutelemora, Le Rata Renaranza Admitwa, because of Banabana, and then Sio Jelwa Tina Masses. Katel, Uchugamelis Begazel, Rebegazel and Yoko, Everton Hohotela is a beautiful godly principle insofar as your husband is godly. Manja into the man attend to Samanda, Izo Tagata egg bambi, pop it on a string, Bese Izo Tagatangi to no mawako, to not support you or protect you when you are suffering. Azo Biza baby, Gantumundo Kona, Uvimeng and Miti, Uguzi U responded in 10, in kind, calling him baby to baby Ganja no Tagatin, baby Ganja no Tagatu Babuam, Utagatu Putua Uputuam, Utangi ignore Mankan, baby Ganja. Utakatu sister wam, Utiang ignore mankala, baby ganjan. How you gonna call me baby when you have bewitched my whole family to ignore my cause? How you gonna call me your lover when you have literally betrayed the name of my family by making one of theirs a little zombie under your spells? Habana sense. And the only reason Maliso is because, like I said, you keep feeding the beast. The other one was of a woman, TikTok, ne? A woman who was telling us a story. So Mama Zala, atagata I gini mbayaha. Umuluile mbahura miscare. Cause ona bata chaltea wana wam shiman. Wana wam shimane msari ona ha this makoti miscarried the baby. She miscarried the baby, right? She was visited by a Mama Zala for a week. Afterwards she miscarried the baby. When she was in hospital, this Mama Zala visits this woman and says that this here miscarriage was a warning, sisters. A warning for you to leave my son alone. Because ever since you came into my son's life, I sent a mali. I got funu gini yezi mali ngoba kwamela ahambe through you, etc. Something of that nature. This woman then goes and tells her husband, "Hore mewa ha un threatenile, and mewa ha utlema hore the reason ki miscarriage anki is because she did witchcraft. Ungeze mpa." She told her husband what her mother told her in hospital. Lom nomfazi nendo talena ya kolwa the mom. He said my mom would never ever do anything like that. He said Umawam would never do it. Like, he did not take the side of the wife. That's just the thing. The Bible says a man must leave his mother and father and cleave to his wife, and the two become one flesh. That's what the Bible has to say. Do you understand what I'm saying? Give baby le ew. Eh. So munna jwanong ha sa khone go tswa mo mmeng wa teng and cleave to mosadi. Ha godly. And it's the thing eki buang ka yona. Basadi ha ba protectan. Mme wa teng wa a sa tlhokomela the needs of Kingi, the daughter-in-law, first and foremost. Why are you protecting the needs of the daughter-in-law, first and foremost, the mom? And why is the son not leaving to his wife that him and his wife might become one flesh? Why is that even a thing? Why is there so much ungodliness between men and women in families that akubona the need ukuvikela the dignity of a woman? Why twenty ulo tepa mme wa hao o tsebang hore o greedy above umfazi wa khona awulali noma. Top of that, you don't give ma abantwana. Uma ought to be grateful for grandchildren on the come up. Like, if at all, a mother, a gafuni, a ma grandchild, diklokhol, ha mme a sa batle diklokhol. How one or one into ailing very terribly, severely wrong with that picture when a mother does not want grandchildren from her son. Don't you see there's something terribly wrong with that? But that's stuff that's happening across the black community. Moms are bewitching sons to basically be their husbands instead of women's husbands. They are sabotaging marriages. There's just all this random strange stuff going on. Hello. There's all this random strange stuff happening all over the show, and it literally does not make any sense at all. Go protectwa banna at the expense of women, and basadi are no longer valuing basic things like grandchildren. Like umama azobloka umchato wendoda kazi yakhe. What? Like mama zala out here bewitching the pregnancy of her daughter-in-law. Like, it's stuff like that is happening in the black community, and it's all over TikTok. Out here, Musadi Unale music in the background, violins playing. You can tell that it's a sad, sad story. When you listen to it, your heart aches. But my thing about that is, Abantu Bamnyama, you have made your lives iserekisi. And then when you go in the comments section, so many people can relate. Stuff like that happens to Thina nje kuphela, Abantu Bamnyama. Just us. Just us. We're the only ones in these streets that can relate at such a grand scale to so many circus tricks. Only ones. And here it is that you want to make me a statistic. Lebatla ungeza, a daughter-in-law that keeps on miscarrying because mama zala gas bayiskelem sam. You want to make me a woman that's going to contract HIV from her husband. Lebatla ungeza side piece, Mr. Rasi. Basically another statistic in the black community. You have all of the indiscretions that slap you coming, guys. Hale protectani. Banna balona batsubile matakwane. Ba feel entitled to basadi. Babatla di side PC, banyetse, and you are letting it happen. Women pride themselves in the black community in being the side piece, in hurting abafazi abatshatile, like proper aguna respect or inhlonipho for a family, a structure, inhliziyo yomfazi. I protect our heartbreak in Jefela is something that is just taken as another Tuesday. It is no wonder we're always called angry black women. So manje, makunjalo, mina ngizwenza ngani? They've got snakes in their houses in order to make money. And catch out the end of a dangela, like puppets on a string, control you with you having no say because that's what's going on. And you are content. You are okay, kama phelo a botlhoko gakalo. Le grande kama phelo a botlhoko gakalo. It is no wonder geleng tshibile nna ke tlhokafala because ke literally onto a God that protected me from all that rubbish. From umamazala o sangelelang gaqweni, o tlongkelang payaka, protected me from a mother that does not want to take care of the needs of her own daughter. Protected me from men ba jekolang, bankang basadi kankane. Protected me from ikorobela. Protected me from women that want all of us to get admitted ibar. He protected me from all of it, and I keep on saying, go to Jesus so that your jealousy won't consume you. Go to Christ so that you won't allow yourself to end up a narcissistic mother that can't even take care of the needs of your own daughter because she's now 25 and gorgeous. Go to Christ that you can protect yourselves from ending up HIV positive in a marriage to some dude or twele who contracted the virus, never mind even from a mistress, but from a sex ritual done for money. Go to God to basically become Abigail, staying David from committing abominations, because la matota lawa have no incentive right now to do differently. No incentive. Right now, kyalla, right hona no, because kila dila zomora kibona. And I keep on getting nightmares because they are literally leaning on tabar. My family is not sufficiently supportive. Basadi are standing back doing nothing. Ba chuswa banna ban, ho hudzwa, ukata, ho rape, mostrating ba yasizwa. And for as long as basizwa, rito nenta rapamura, kinto kibuang il. Marahaling rata ker, len nakile rat. Kresha, go fell away in this together. I don't like you anymore, black people. I am tired of you. But I have to keep on addressing you. Why? Because, like TikTok, right? I keep on getting clumped with you in all of your indiscretion to a point where I can't even run away from all of your nastiness being recommended to me by TikTok, even though I'm not logged in. Because, like I said, I am being beaten to a pulp by my own skin because I can't get out of it. Your indiscretions are horrendous. You are destroying yourselves, calamitizing yourself, dropping like dominoes. Ra bolawa on the daily. Marales baiskelemosal stop by the carnage. You are happy to be strewn like cadavers all over these streets, insofar as you're not the only one. Alright, do you? But all I can say is, Christ is the only way out of your insanity. If you want him, take him. If you don't, by all means, do what you want to do. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. I'm signing out in Christ's name. Kran K. Karab. Bye.